everyone. Welcome to the sixth tutorial in this series. This time I will be focusing on movements for both characters and the video. These will include different character actions such as walking, and I'll go over video styles such as zooms and POVs. Now let's get into the tutorial. The most important part for movements are graphs. I already covered graphs in the third tutorial, but this time I'll go over which graphs you should use for each part of an animation. For characters that are idle or walking, no graphs are really needed. They become more useful for attacks. For when there is a quick movement such as a punch, grab, or dive, I would recommend an out graph. These include ease, quad, and cubic out. Ease is the slowest, while cubic is the fastest. Try them all out before deciding which speed best suits your animation. And once you have chosen, add the same graph to every limb and character's part of the attack. Moving on to a slower animation segment, such as picking up heavy objects and blocking against a laser. In graphs are optimal. This time, ease in is the fastest and cubic is the slowest, but still try each graph out and add it to every overlay in the animation. The animation ends with another fast movement, so add out graphs to this part too. With my graph tips explained, I'll move on to some character movements. For this part of the tutorial, I'll show you how to animate different movements. These include an idle, walking, running, turning, and flying animation. The first way to animate an idle character is by adding long-distance keyframes and moving the overlay slightly forwards and backwards between them. Another method to make a character appear less static is by adding a small shake effect to them. On video effects, find the shake effect and add it to the project. Place the effect onto the character by pressing Object and selecting the character overlay. Finally, decrease the intensity of the effect on Adjust. Now I'll move on to some walking and running animations. A walking animation is easy. Just distance the keyframes and drag the overlay across it. As for a run, I like to tilt the character forwards into their direction. Add a closer keyframe at the start of the run to tilt the character earlier in the animation. And now I'll cover how to do a turn. You will need three close distanced keyframes for this animation, and then split the overlay for when the character turns. On the first half, rotate the character downwards at the last keyframe, and then rotate them down on the first keyframe in the second half. Time to finish this part with some flying tips. Animate a moving airborne character with excessive leans and lunges to show their weight. I also like to scale them up and down to show their distance from the background. And don't forget to improve the animation with some graphs. Also, never add two in or two out graphs next to each other, as they will ruin the animation's flow. I will finish off flying by showing you how to smoothly move multiple overlays off-screen at once. Start off by adding keyframes to drag every connected overlay off-screen. Then scroll back to when the connected limb should last be visible on screen. For this example, when the cannon is barely in the frame, add a keyframe to the connection and simply move the overlay back into place to make them both drag out smoothly. And those are some of my movement tips. This section of the tutorial will go over some video effects such as camera panning and heavy impacts. Add these effects to an already exported animation in a separate project. Starting with camera panning, all you need to do is add keyframes to the video and zoom it in and out to focus on certain characters at a time. This can be useful for hiding static characters by moving the camera towards another animation. In this example, the laser charging is hidden with the zoom to the background shooting. And finish off by adding graphs between the keyframes to improve the panning even more. Now to make a heavy impact, I add two CapCut effects to the video. The first one is Shake Again. I set the speed and intensity at around 15, and then make sure the effect covers where the impact is taking place. The second effect I add is called Snow Glitch, which adds a strong static effect to the video. Shithead. To finish this tutorial, I'll go over how to do a POV animation. I've set up a POV animation in this project. Use hand models and do a large zoom in the background to start. I will demonstrate a small running animation. Make the character move along the map by zooming in the background further. Add keyframes to animate the arms. For a run, they will pop in and out the frame. Add short distance keyframes to make this animation. Place them at the same time on both overlays and have one arm in the frame at a time. Then simply repeat this process until the background is fully zoomed in. And now I'll show what effects to add to this animation. I usually add a lens effect. To do this, you'll need to add a lens overlay to the project. Make it transparent by pressing Splice, then Filter. Then decrease the slider to around 30 to make it more transparent, and zoom it in to cover the screen. Finally, add low intensity shake effects to the background and arms to the animation. And that's it for this tutorial. Hope you found my tips and ideas useful. If you need any additional support, you should comment on this video or join my server. Thank you for watching, everyone. I'll see you soon.